The blessing of the Lord brings wealth without painful toil for it. Proverbs chapter 10, verses 22.
Hello, family. A very warm welcome back to the Lovystouch Food Channel. Thank you so much for coming back. This happens to be the very first recipe for the year 2024. Let's grill some fish. I am a big fan of fish, so this year we are starting off by grilling the most tastiest, the most juiciest, the most delicious croaker fish. The marinade is what makes everything stand out, so please, please, and please again pay attention to that. Let's go and get something and cooking. Happy New Year once again. I love you all. Have a great day.
So let's go through our ingredients. Here I have my fish. I'm using croaker fish today. And these all other ingredients are going to be used as marinade. It is very, very important to pay attention to them. I have my garlic powder. I also have my herb mix, which I'm going to list each and every one below in the description box. I also have some onion, ginger, habanero pepper, and I also have some parsley. They are fresh parsley that I use. I also have some spring onions, some leeks, and I'm going to add my homemade shrimp seasoning. I've shared this recipe long time ago on this channel. I'm going to link it here and below. It is very, very tasty. I'm going to use my food processor to mix everything together, and I'll go back and add my herb mix, garlic powder, and my smoked paprika powder. And I'm going to also squeeze about half a lime on it and make sure I mix everything together. Here, to make sure everything is nice and smooth, I'm going to add about 1 to 3 tablespoons of cooking olive oil. Mix every single thing together. It is so, so important. Okay, and I also add about a tablespoon of salt. All right, this is so, so, so amazing. So now I've cleaned, washed, and really, really taken good care of this fish. I am going to now go ahead and make some incisions so that all these marinades will be able to penetrate through the fish, enhancing the taste and the aroma of this fish. Okay, it is very, very important stage of your grilled fish. Any grilled fish you're doing, make sure you do this. Okay, this is what we got. It is absolutely great. So now we're going to go ahead and marinate it very well with our awesome marinade. This marinade is very golden. If you make sure you follow the steps, you're going to get the best marinade of all times. And any time that I get the time to make it, I make sure I make it a little bit more so that I will save the rest for later. You can use this for your fish, your chicken, even your beef as well. It is absolutely great. Make sure you are very generous with it, okay? Once you're done marinating the other side, make sure you turn the other side and marinate that as well. I am very much particular with the head because that's my favorite part. Marinate it very, very well and go ahead, cover it. Allow it to rest for about 30 minutes while you go ahead and prep for your oven form. I like to cover the bottom of my oven form with my aluminum foil just to prevent the fish from sticking under the button. You know, I do not like to do extra work afterwards. I also added a little bit of olive oil and then place my fish, making sure I do not waste the extra or excess marinade. Make sure you are so generous with this, okay? I added a bit of olive oil just to make sure that all the marinade has been grasped well by this fish. And I also added a few bit of lime just to tone down the fishy smell once it is in the oven. It is very important. I also went ahead to preheat my oven at 160 degrees for about 8 minutes and then put it in. My extra marinade, however, which is very golden to me, I'm going to put it in the ice cubes. I'm going to use this whenever I'm going to grill my next fish, chicken, or meat. Okay, it is so, so important. So while waiting for the fish to get ready, it's going to be in the oven for about 20 minutes. I'm going to go ahead and fry some golden, beautiful, soft, ripe plantain. Always pleasant to pair your grilled fish with some fried plantain. You may choose to also fry some potatoes or yam or even some kinki. My goodness, it is such a perfect combo. Today we rested ourselves and just delighted ourselves so well with this fried plantain. They are so gorgeous. Just look at that. We Ghanaians love to just cut us in the diamond shapes, which is absolutely perfect. I went ahead to season it with 1/2 tablespoon of salt and add about 1 cup of water just to make sure that everything is nice seasoned with the salt. Just allow this to sit for about 5 minutes before you start to fry them. They are so beautiful. I love me some fried plantain. They are so, so naughty, but they are so good, okay? What a way to start the year, right? So once my plantains are nicely caramelized, I'm going to take out them from the oil. You may also decide to fry them in your air fryer or in your oven if you do not want to start your year with some oil issues, okay? So look at those golden babies, and they're looking amazing. I'm done frying all my plantain. I thought of sauteing some veggies to go with this. So I chopped a few green peppers, some red onions, and some cabbage. That cabbage and the crunch that comes with it is everything you need. So I'm going to go ahead, put a little bit of olive oil in my pot and add all these vegetables. You can decide to use any veggies that you prefer, okay? I season with some all-purpose seasoning and my marinade that I use for the fish. It is so, so good. I just want everything to incorporate well. So just stir it for about 2 minutes and you are good to go. After 18 to 20 minutes of grilling my fish in the oven, the fish came out so nice and juicy. We are done. We need to give this fish a very nice treat, so I'm going to transfer it on a very nice plate just to make sure that presentation, it is popping there as well, because you cannot have this fish and just present it anyhow, okay? I'm going to put my stir-fried veggies on the side and also my fried plantain. Just look at this gorgeousness. Tell me you don't want to have a bite. Absolutely amazing. Food is great. It is delicious, but how you present it also has a great impact on your food and how people even perceive it, okay? So just look at this. When you not try it this weekend for the family, please do, because it is absolutely great. We dig in and it was absolutely great. Have some sobolo on the side to push everything down and you are good to go. The crunch from the veggies were so, so delicious. So there you have it, family. This brings us to the end. I really hope you enjoyed this recipe and you're going to just give it a shot. This goes out to all my fish lovers. If you enjoyed this recipe, please be sure to give me a thumbs up, share with your friends and family as well. Please comment below. As you already know, I love to read from you. Let me know what your thoughts are, okay? And if this is your first time here, hello, my name is Lovia from Lovystouch. My main goal here is to cheer you up into making your own delicious meal right at the comfort of your home. I also love to share kitchen related motivational videos, so please come on board and subscribe to join the family for amazing new recipes every week. Thank you so very much, family, for watching once again. And as always, know that you are so beautiful just the way you are. I will see you in my next one. Have a blessed day. Bye.